Hello, Monsters of Banhood, welcome back to Total War Warhammer 2 Mortal Empires and part 29 of my Naggaroth campaign. Last time we captured the Castle Artois. That's right. Oh, that was good. It was a good siege. Good little siege. And yeah, really did prove herself. But Alice is still
not yet ready.
Nope, there we go. So Alice is still being a massive prick. We're racing to the defense of Elfland because Elfland is in trouble.
Beyond your comprehension.
We've got some nasty Chaos Warriors heading this way. Enya is soon to be joined by Alice, something I'm sure she is thrilled by. I'm sure she cannot wait to have her boss,
loyal and
constantly
capable,
belittling boss, turn up to basically make her life a misery. We're going to give Alfred an Elven Steed so he can keep moving. Yes, yes, I know what an Elven Steed is. Thank you very much.
I do not know them well.
Mel is getting... hard to hit? Sure.
Protect Elvolfwan.
And Feanor to Dain in the north is basically mopping up the Norskans while they're busy elsewhere. They do have a fleet over here. And I'm giving the settlements to the Wood Elves to look after because the Wood Elves aren't at war with the Norskans. The Norskans can't do anything about it.
I travel the world seeking jewels. Today you bring one to me.
Well, not really. Not really. And as we're killing Norska and also the vampires, Throg is actually kind of on our side, weirdly, so we might be able to get a nice little non-aggression with him, maybe. Amon. We're going to go with... Well, actually, this is interesting, because we could get more income from entertainment buildings. We do, well... I think more income from trade is probably just going to be better, though. Let's get that. Let's do that. That sounds pretty good. Shaggy is... I'm kind of tempted to bring Shaggy down here to maybe see if we can find out what some of the other factions are doing. Who's down here? Thegan's Errantry. Okay. And the thing is, Shaggy is just kind of fine. You know what? Let's bring Shaggy back.
Destruction.
So we can keep an eye on what's going on over here. We'll just get more influence as we go. So that works out quite nicely. Feanor to Dain, you... Can you reach? No. In that case, if we... Oh, no, that's Throg territory, isn't it? We don't want to head over to Throg territory. We want to head to Grayling Moot. Let's go over here. We can hit Grayling Moot. We can hit Doom Keep. Give those to the Wood Elves. It's like we've got an idle army down here. Ah, it's Wulfric. Wulfric's down here. Well, I think Faye can easily deal with Wulfric. That should be no problem. Vesper seems to be following us. Not sure where she's going. Might be coming down to help us. I'm expecting once we've destroyed this Chaos army... then we might get more Chaos forces spawning. So we need to keep that in mind. And Scarf over here is... I don't really know what to do with him. So we're just going to kind of stay there, I guess. Seems fine. Hagreef. Oh, we can upgrade to the Dark Crag. Everyone loves a good old Dark Crag.
Blood of Naggaroth in them.
And, oh, Foe Seeker, I guess. I don't really know what to do with you, Shaggy. You're just so good. It's hard to know. Gisero got sacked. I could give it to the Empire, but I'm going to be honest, it's probably going to get captured. I'm just not that bothered. I mean, we're kind of carving out a nice little space here. The Empire does have recruitment grounds. It is got some more settlements. If we can keep them safe for a little while, especially while Karl returns from his honeymoon, he and Theodore were honeymooning up in the icy wastes of Naggarond. It's not for everyone. I would be concerned that Frostbite might be an issue, but they seem to, you know, their love for each other is keeping them warm, and that is a lovely sentiment. Beautiful in its own way.
Keep your demands short. I weary of mortal concerns.
Hello, Noctilus. You want a peace treaty? I mean, you're not really a threat to me. On the other hand, you're not really a threat to me at... screw it. Nope. We're going to stay at war. Just for the moment. Well, regrettably, Jar Jar Binks has been torn limb from limb by a werewolf. So, a moment's celebration there. And Elfland has been besieged, but we're okay. We've got less construction. I probably should have built that a long time ago. Researched it anyway. Invocation of Vol is... Good. Sea Legs, sure. Yeah, whatever. Sea Legs, good. Don't care. What I do care about is this. What we got? Blade of Sea Gold, armor piercing damage, but less weapon damage. A Blessed Tome, which gives all allies in line leadership, boring. Staff of Solidarity, miscast chance, boring. Sapphire Guardian Phoenix. Magic resistance, boring. Well, that's a pile of wank, isn't it? Hmm?
Asurion protects us.
Yeah, well, he certainly doesn't give us any good fucking shit. Look at this, this is garbage. What the hell? I mean, I mean, I am legitimately overwhelmed with the pointlessness of this choice. I guess magic resistance is better than nothing? Well, that was chronically disappointing.
I serve the Phoenix King. For the Phoenix King.
Okay, well, we'll go and capture this. Kill everyone there. Loot and occupy. Before I forget, let's get military advancements 4. Because then we can get all that kind of good stuff. Excellent. And Faye will leave you to replenish for
too
a turn.
Southern blood in them.
And we'll give you... You've got Bowmaster, so that's fine. Let's go with Favourable Wind. Just, you know, more missile damage. Yes, we won't affect any of our units yet. They're very soon. A lot of these people are just on the cusp. A lot of these units are just on the cusp of reaching the next rank, the gold chevron.
And, the city is crumbling.
Yeah, well, that's, you know... That's
a
thing. Right, you, my old mucko, are in my way. Get out of here.
Rally to me, Asur.
Bop.
Hoef guides me.
Shadow armor. Sure. And then let's kill these guys. Hello there. A little ambush.
Asur, we fight.
Don't mind if I do. Oh, I love a good ambush. And already that hell cannon is effectively out of commission. And down he goes. And down go the Chaos Dwarves. Bye, guys. Right, that's that problem dealt with. However, we've got several more problems, because there's Chaos Trolls, there's Chaos Spawn, there's lots of chariots and Chaos Knights all charging up the hill towards us. But fortunately, we do have a nice commanding position up here. Look at this. This is pretty good. These Chaos Chariots are already taking a lot of fire. They're going to break just before they reach our line. There we go. And these guys are going to charge straight into the Keeper of the Flame. That would be a mistake. I would not want to charge them directly to the front. Silver Helm's going to engage these Chaos Traps, lock them down. We've got some Silver Helms held in reserve there. Enya flying around. She's already breathed fire over some of the Chaos Warriors, who are slightly slower than the rest of their army, which is useful because it means we can deal with these Chaos Knights, which is exactly what we're doing here. Chaos Knights clashing up against the Loth and Sea Guard and taking quite a lot of punishment there. That's working quite well. We've got a big old blob. These Chaos Knights retreating away from the fight. They've had enough. And we're going to drop the Dwellers Below, which it does quite a lot of damage. Doesn't kill many, but it does slow them down as well. So we're going to slow them down. And then, as they try and advance up the hill, they're just going to get shot with arrow fire. Okay, the chariot's coming again. Yeah, trying to charge into the Lothan Sea God. One of the reasons why the Lothan Sea God are so strong is because they can just take cavalry charges. And cavalry charges, of course, one of the ways you really deal with missile units. And the Lothan Sea God are just kind of immune to it. They've got super high melee defense and charge resistance. And that's why they're so good. So the Fireborn now just chasing down the last few units. Lots of the Chaos Knights going to get away, but most of their infantry, of course, quite slow infantry. And so they're going to just get shot in the back as they try and fall back. So we'll have to deal with the rest of this army. Slight problem might be that it might spawn another wave of Chaos. Could be a bit problematic, but, you know, has to be done. Nothing short of absolute butchery there. Deaths are necessary.
Put them to death.
Yeah, sure, why not? Assistance? I'm slightly concerned that by doing this, I might spawn
more thingy bobs.
But Talisman of Safari. Rubbish. Do I want...
Entering the city.
Who do I want to have?
We march on.
That stupid thing that I just picked up.
Taking up residence.
Enya.
I do not know them well.
What is it? It's not one of those. Oh, right. It's a talisman. I mean, your talisman's already friggin' amazing, so we're not going to replace that. Maybe we can give it to... you?
I serve the king.
Good to know. Right, you can have a healing potion, because why not? Have one of them. Have, that. We don't have any weapons you can have. You can have a The Banner of the Barrows is quite nice. Sure, you can have it. And the Gleaming Pennant. You can have a bard. You can have one of them. And what about someone to drink wine with? I mean, sure.
I serve the
Can't argue with that. And, oh right, we've got these guys. Been at war with them for ages. They haven't done anything. They haven't even moved. We can get the amphitheatre. Come see the wondrous sights, the dazzling spectacle, the astronomical prices. I can imagine. Holy shit. Gah. Just, oh, so expensive. What's the problem with the theatre?
Defender of the Everqueen.
I could go and grab this thingy.
I will do my duty.
Okay, well, first grab this. Loot the carcass. Really?
They must die for order.
Are you sure?
It must be done.
I don't...
Their deaths are necessary.
All right. I do not agree with just how brutal that auto-resolve was, because this should not be hard to deal with. I do have a couple of pieces of artillery. That's fair. But I'm going to be honest. I've got more. And yes, their artillery is better. Still. They've got less artillery now. They've only got one cannon left. Dragons are flapping around the flanks there. They're going to go and try and deal with the mortars. So we just got one last cannon to deal with. I've told my bolt throwers to target them. Just like that. And down he goes. Lovely. Okay, now the dragons just need to deal with the mortars over here, who are opening fire. And I'm going to be honest, not doing a huge amount of damage. We're going to move up at the same time. Here come the dragons. Get some fire breath on there. That'll do it. I think it's pretty much safe to ignore these guys now, to be honest. I don't think it's going to be an issue. We'll leave the bolt throwers to finish them off. And here come the zombies right into the face of my arrows. My archers, little bit of magic there, cuts down a lot of them. Oh, absolute carnage. Zombie carnage. Over here, the Swordmasters of Hoeth. I mean, I'm going to work them, make them earn their pay. Plus, we've got some hand cannons over here. So they're going to be opening fire. Yeah, those hand cannons are not very good. Not very good. So these gunnery mob here is going to get charged. They managed to tie up two of our units, but fortunately we've got three units of Swordmasters. So the Swordmaster's going to come in and just lock these zombies to pieces. Not going to be particularly difficult for them. Down they go. And the Vampire Fleet Captain is, is being made to dance. Dance, monkey, dance. Running hither and thither, trying to dodge all the arrows. Not doing very well. Still got several arrows buried in the side of our head. Not the best place for arrows, I'll be honest. Let's have a little shot there. How's that going? Not great. Gonna try and hide behind a tree? Yes. Not working out great for you, is it? Right, well, that wasn't really 60% in my favour, was it? That was...
It must be done.
Okay, never mind. Let's stab people for the experience. Now we get some more money. I was hoping for a buff. But money's fine too. Okay, let's hop over here. Fresh Prince has leveled up. Oh, brilliant. So you've got a lot of Sea Guards. So it does make sense to go for Mathlin, I guess. But it is a bit boring. You've got dragons as well. White lions are a bit naff. You do have some swordmasters. We could maybe go swordmasters, but... Phoenix Guard. Oh, I think maybe just math. I mean, we're kind of buffing up how much money our ports make anyway, so... Let's go with that. Defender of the Phoenix Throne. Let's go with that. And we probably want defences here, ideally, so we should probably see about getting that done. Okay, sure, whatever. Where are you? Dargoth. You are inland, so there's no point worrying too much about that. We've only got one port here, so we may as well just go for the Elven Gardens. Makes more sense to get the plaza, I think. Sure. No, wait, Shargath is on the coast, so let's go with defences. Let's get some walls there. Wall it up, boys.
Their name carries little honour.
Holy shit. Enya, the best Elven general. I guess we go Merchant Lord?
I do not know them well.
So we've got the melee defense and physical resistance for the Phoenix Guard. Silver Torrent. It would give more missile no, that's not for... Silver Helms. We could do this. Because actually, I quite like my Silver Helms. I didn't think I would. I thought I'd replace them. But actually, I've kind of attached to them now.
Too much southern blood in
them. You've got two skill points. Holy shit. Okay, Merchant Lord. More tradable goods. I don't know if we've got the people to trade with them, but sure. I wonder if we could send a faction to go and help... If we could send a faction army to go and help the dwarves out, we could link up with them, get to trade with them as well. I mean, if the wood elves can knock out Carcassonne, then they could also trade with us. Might mean killing some of our potential allies, but...
A master of his chosen art.
But such is life. Let's get magical reserves, because that'd be quite nice.
I serve the Phoenix King.
Tilly, you did great in your first battle, Tilly. I just want to point that out. Absolutely brilliant. We're going to give you a weapon master. You've got two skill points.
Not yet ready.
Replenishment troop. Yeah, replenish troops, because we might need it. That'll mean we're good to go. Aleth.
Upon the waves.
If you come down here, then you should be good to attack, drive back Steiner, and make sure we keep Castle Artois. We can come down here, save Gissero from Luke, the Troubadour, and then move on Leon Essie and Mousselon, and we'll have the entirety of Bretonnia back under our control, and we can force down through the mountains all the way to Paravon, link up with the Wood Elves, clean out Bretonnia, and then head into the Empire. I want to have a good old nose around.
At once.
See what's up. I don't think... Oh, I was going to say they didn't... Wow, you've got a lot of... That's a lot of vampires. A lot of triplets, in fact. Verena, Rosalinda, and Sophie. Oh, Sophie Gorst. It's Gorst's sister, apparently.
By Anar's
I think he only had brothers, but maybe it's a cousin or something.
Never.
Okay, six turns, we get marked for death. This guy's costing me a lot of money, though. But, I mean, I've got a lot of money anyway, so I think it's probably fine. You just stay there for a moment, buddy. We'll leave that, because we might lose that. And Amon, can you... Whoever this guy is, you can't assassinate him, but can we secure influence?
Smash it to ruins.
Nope, apparently not. Never mind. Don't care about that. End turn.
Keep your demands short. I weary of mortal concerns.
What's up, Heinrich? You want a peace treaty for 4K? No. No, 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 no. Gonna pull your beard out through your bottom. Just reach all the way up in there, grab it, and then just pull. That is a vivid mental image I had just experienced. Very vivid. Don't know how to feel about that. Both confused and aroused. A bit. That's just my thing. Yeah, I thought we might lose this. No biggie. You're going to capture it? You just sacked it. Okay, sure. Whatever. You sack away. Not really that bothered. They stole 91 monies. Wow. And we got military advancements 4. Wulfric here. Where's Wulfric? Where's Wulfric? And a Doomtide. Ah, so that she means we've got more. Oh, yes, so they are. Found them. Lovely. Okay, let's come down and defend Slaver's Point. The Twisted Glade might come under attack as well, and they'll probably hit the coast. But that's fine. Steel technology, blah, 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 blah. Fine, no problem. Right, can we... We can attack you, but I think what I'll do is probably just head to Gisero and defend it. And then we've got Alice here, who can, if we come down here, then next turn we can... Yeah, the next turn we can either, like, use the underway. What's it called? Shadow Realms. We can use the Shadow Realms.
Princess.
Or just go and kill them all. Either way, it'll work. Enya, do I want Woundmaker? Sure. I mean, you've already got stupid amounts of weapon damage. And Elfland will have... Yeah, I know. We'll be upgradable in 4 turns. 4 lovely turns. What tech? So weapon damage and melee attack for Phoenix and Dragon. That could be quite good for Blue Squadron. So I'm kind of... The hotter it is, the wilder the beast. So intrinsic is fire to their nature. Ooh. Ooh, but ward save for Dragon Princes. I've only got 1 unit of Dragon Princes. No, 2 units of Dragon Princes. Let's get Fireborn Nature, just because I kind of want it. Can we reach... We can reach Wulfric. Goodness me, that's a lot of mammoths. That is a shit ton. I believe that is the technical term is a shit ton of mammoths there. That is a lot of mammoths.
Do not displease me.
Wow.
I will not.
Princess of the Azure.
That's quite a few mammoths. Can we reach Doomkeep? No.
Your command.
They are actually reducing chaos corruption here quite a lot. At some point, it's going to be safe to just walk through. Okay, when can we do the thing of Aisha? 20 turns. Ah, that's quite a wait.
Your best.
I kind of want to get him in an ambush. We might be able to. Okay, if we give Grayling Moot to the Wood Elves... We do that.
Azure Lady.
That's going to give us more melee defense. So if we like scooch over here,
we go. Preparing camp.
We won't suffer attrition. We might be able to lure them in towards us. They might come charging after us, and if they do, we then jump them and see if we can get an ambush. Because if we get an ambush, I reckon we can. I mean, these mammoths—they're are quite tanky.
You may approach.
I think we'll be alright. Famous last words. It'll be a tough fight though, because that is a lot of mammoths. Significant mammoth levels in that army. Right, we'll go and kill these guys. Amadri Ironbark, because he's just been sat there, just basically just hurling insults at us for quite a while, and I've got sick of it. Shadow falls. Yeah, you can. Oh, Heinrich is there. I could kill you.
Your command.
I could kill you, but I don't see the point. Okay, let's. I want defense. Slaver's points. Defenses. Knees defenses. The sea churns. Twisted Glaive, you are in trouble. I could get just another general down here. We could get someone like Thalos. Oh, it's going to cost almost 6k just to recruit the army. That's just not worth it. I reckon Toranlek will be alright. They've got, okay, White Lions, as people pointed out, don't have much melee defense, so need to use those in a different way, but I think we can. I think we're alright. I think we're okay. So I am going to just, we've got an army up here. Fresh Prince can go and knock out all of these units, all these armies, just one by one. They split up. Hopefully they will. We might lose a couple of settlements, but I think generally we'll be okay. When can I upgrade you? I can. No, I can't. Don't have... Wait. Right, yeah, no, because you're not upgraded. Right, yeah, that makes sense. Okay, fine. I was confused. It easily happens. Okay, Vampiric Corruption is dropping, is climbing. Osmosis. Oh, I imagine they've got lots of Vampiric Corruption in the Reichlands. So we need to sort that out. Karl has arrived at his new home in Corone. That's nice. He's been travelling for quite a while, but he's now turned up. Good to see. Won't worry too much about that. Amon just killed himself. He drank too much at a party. And, that's unfortunate. He's had to be wheeled off to get his stomach pumped. That is always a danger when you go to parties as frequently as he does. He's effectively an alcoholic at this point. You get around to his place. It's just bottles everywhere. He just sequests them in random locations in his house, and it's a real problem. It's sad in some ways, and I feel partly responsible because I'm the one that keeps sending him to these parties as part of his job. So, you know, I have to take responsibility for my part in that. That's my cross to bear.
Don't presume to stride where I patrol. That will be a fatal error.
I mean, more for you, more problem, Alice, because I imagine Skrulk is very leaky. It's probably more a snail trail of moistness behind him. Peace Treaty, no. Nope, because we've got someone coming down to kick the shit out of you, Skrulk. Well, not you personally, but one of your, you know, people.
You summon the Shadow King. Do you serve with the Warriors of Naggarith?
I don't think he does, actually. Military access? No. Arcan? No. None of that. Be gone.
You approach a dark throne. I pray you bring only light.
Hello. No, not you. No, because the Wood Elves... I'm kind of hoping the Wood Elves kill you, actually. Just between... Well, not you and me, because obviously that would be telling you that I want you to die, but I just kind of want... I want to be able to trade with the Wood Elves, and I think you're kind of in... You're standing in the way of that. So I would prefer you a little bit more dead. If possible. Just throwing it out there.
Come in peace. Perhaps you may even leave Naggarith that way too.
Troll Skulls, you want a non-aggression pact. I guess so. I mean, I've got no strong feelings about you.
Eternal. Nevertheless,
hello, let me guess, you want a peace treaty. Oh, suddenly, Suddenly you don't want money for it. Is that because I've got a very large army nearby? Tell you what, Amadri, you can stuff it. Okay, let's see what these servants to chaos do. Okay, heading to Slaver's Point, that's fine. Okay, sure, no problem. Fine. Yep. That's okay. Alright. Okay. I think that's fine. Been assaulted. Okay, not a die-in, but fortunately that won't have affected her too much. And a critical failure. Now, Highborn. I could go and grab Doomkeep.
If you will it.
For the I think that's what we're going to do.
Asur, attack! Now is not the time.
Oh, that's quite a big army. Do I fight this one to try and limit casualties?
For Asurion.
Hmm.
The Kadai watch over us.
Ooh, do I? Do I?
Asur, to battle.
Oh, you know what? I haven't killed Norskans in a while, so...
The Kadai watch over us.
Why not? Trolls aren't taking too much damage. I'm going to throw a little fireball at them, see how much damage that does. Fireball, fireball, fireball. Boff. I mean, that was not bad. Don't know if it was worth a fireball. Did it kill one? Yeah, it did. He's not moving. Nope, he's dead. Good. Lovely. Okay, we're going to try and take out this mammoth, because mammoths are horrible. Nasty. I mean, you know, super, super strong. But also, they've got a weird trunk that's a little bit... Looks like a tentacle claw. It's weird. We're going to send the Phoenix to go and engage it in combat. Flies down. Just going to nip it in the bottom. That should get its attention. Boff. There you go. He's gone out of control. The dragon is going to land down in amongst these Norsican warhounds. Take those out. That's quite good. And the trolls have run straight into our archers. And they've now shattered. Running for their lives. As have... The Marauders. They're also advancing straight into us. There's quite a lot of Marauders on our left flank. So we're going to move the Silver Helms over to the right to try and fend off these guys. And we've got some more Silver Helms on the left. And the Feral Mammoth is out of control. We're going to pull out the Phoenix before it can get trapped. And then bring it back to engage these Marauder Hunters. Silver Helms leading the units on the right flank, or our left flank. A merry little dance. We're going to try and pull them away. And on the right flank, we're going to just breathe fire all over these Marauders. Like so. Oh, that was pretty good. And then charge. And we can get another little charge over here. And that should work out quite nicely. Absolute slaughter. And then we're going to get a nice little charge on this flank. Oh, beautiful. Look at this. All the Silverhelm charges. I mean, I will be the first to hold my hands up and say I am not good with cavalry the vast majority of the time. But when it comes together, it comes together. Got some more champions here. That looks like Mel is fighting. And Sisters opening fire. Taking them out. Phoenix flying overhead, landing in amongst them to debuff their melee attack. And there we go. They're running for their lives. Sister of Avalon taking out these Marauders with great weapons, getting shot to pieces. We probably took a lot less damage than if we'd done the auto resolve. This was not meant to be. Just one of those cases where I feel like the auto resolve would have dicked me over.
Take anything of value.
Let's loot and occupy. Got some gambler's armor, that's nice. Excellent. Right, Doom Key. So we should replenish pretty... Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. We actually do have some defenses here as well. But it could be worth trying some... Wait, where did... Okay, Wulfric's actually run away. I thought that was Wulfric. It is not.
A staunch champion.
So... You can... Let's get Comet of Cassandora. Let's get Comet of Cassadora. That seems fine. Right, so we're giving lots of stuff to the Wood Elves, and actually that's paying off because Vampiric Corruption, Chaos Corruption is dropping wildly. Look at this. Buildings, commandments, it's just nosediving. At some point, this will no longer be, we'll no longer take attrition for travelling across this territory, which will be great. What do they actually have? Sacrificial Grounds. Oh, does this just, oh, it just generically gives Untainted. Okay, cool. Excellent. I'm dropping there as well. I say, the more stuff we give to the Wood Elves, less Chaos Corruption is going to be. And then we can knock out the Norskans, and that will stop raiding on our coast. And at this rate, we might actually spawn Archaon. I don't know. We've definitely got a lot of fleets down here to deal with. Two coming to the south, four coming to the north. Twisted Glade does have defenses. We might be able to lure. Your will is done. We might be able to lure some of these Chaos fleets in this direction. If we maybe try and set up an ambush, they might see this as an undefended point and a beeline for it. And then we can just murder them one by one. Easy peasy. And Toran Lek is fine. Don't think we've got a problem there. And we can also go and kill this guy, who's been a bit of a pest. Ooh, he's got a forest dragon. No problem. We can kill forest dragons. Easy peasy. But that is going to have to wait until next time. Thank you very much for watching. And I'll see you in the next episode of the Naggaroth campaign.